An elephant suffered grievous injuries just a couple of years ago in the forests of Tamil Nadu. It was suffering and suffering, nearer and nearer to death. Finally, a few weeks ago, it entered into a water body, which many forest officials saw as a sign that this elephant was perhaps giving up and it was ready to die. They kicked into action and tried to convince this poor injured Jumbo to come and get some help. They gave it some medicines, but it wouldn't. What happened next, their plan B, was an absolute miracle. And India Today's Pramod Madhav went to the Mudumalai National Park and Forest to bring us this exclusive, heartwarming story.
An injured and scared wild elephant can turn lethal in a matter of minutes. This was the predicament faced by these forest officials when they first encountered the injured elephant in Tamil Nadu's Mudumalai National Park. One look at his wounds, the officials knew he was in no condition to be tranquilized. They had to bring out their big guns. These four trained tuskers, known as Kumkis, knew their job pretty well.
We are inside a deep forest at Cuddalore where an operation is occurring behind us, where you could see a wild elephant is being tried, persuaded to be brought down by several large Kumkis. Kumkis are trained elephants, and there you could see the elephant in the middle that has a huge wound, and it is causing a lot of trouble to the elephant, which has been there for almost 2 years. Wildlife officials claim that they have tried to actually heal it using a lot of measures, by even providing medicine, but because of the wound's nature, what's happening is that the medicine could not be kept properly, and they are trying as much as possible to bring the elephant to the camp from this forest area, where it could be placed inside a trawl and it can be kept under 24 hours observation.
The whole rescue operation took a painstaking 3 hours, with the injured tusker trying to make a run every next moment. The Kumkis helped in getting their injured tusker to an elephant camp in Mudumalai forest.
The elephant had injury because of some fraternal fight, old fight. So once it came to the notice, we administered medicine through some fruits from a distance. There was some healing, but it could not sustain. And now the problem seems to have increased. Then only this rescue mission was launched.
After several hours of struggle and more than 50 men at this location with four giant Kumkis, the wild tusker has been rescued and has been taken into a truck currently. From here, it will be transported to a camp. And the veterinarians at this place claim that now the treatments that could be provided to it, it has a lot of chance to survive. With Virajan's Divyan, Pramod Madhav, for India Today.
So this beautiful, gentle animal, which refused to take any help because it was injured, it was suffering for at least 2 years. Imagine the amount of suffering after that terrible wound it received on its back. For 2 years, it refused any help because it was nervous, probably didn't have any trust. It is not known how it got this injury. And then finally, using the Kumkis, these trained elephants, this young elephant that had been injured was finally coaxed. It was gently persuaded to come and get some real help, and this animal is now in actual recovery, in the care of experts, in the care of forest officials, and hopefully will be okay very, very soon. That festering wound is currently being treated. I'm going to be joined in just a moment by Kishan Kumar Kaushal, who's the additional principal chief conservator of forests there. He's the officer who was responsible for this operation and was able to save this dying elephant. Mr. Kaushal, welcome. Thank you for being with me on this show. First of all, congratulations on a very heartwarming operation. It's lovely to see that this injured elephant was rescued in this manner. Can you tell us and can you educate us, how was this done, sir? Because many people are wondering, you used some trained elephants to convince this injured elephant to come and get help. How was this done, sir?
Hello.
Can you hear me, Mr. Kaushal?
I am able to hear, but very feeble, not very clear.
Okay, my question to you, I'll try and be a little louder because I know you're in a place where there is not much signal. I'll repeat my question, Mr. Kaushal. Can you explain to us how did you get these kumkis, these elephants, to convince this injured jumbo to come and get medical help, sir? It's amazing to all of us.
Yeah. Actually, what happens, you know, this is a landscape, their country's 1/4 elephants are found in the jungle.
Yes.
Out of 30,000 elephants in the country, 9,000 elephants are found in this landscape. Mudumalai and adjoining like Bandipur, Nagarhole, etc. Whichever elephant is incorrigible, which goes and kills people or raids the crops, or any elephant which is disabled, those are maintained in the camp. Camp means whenever any elephant is brought inside, it is kept in an enclosure for 2 to 3 months. And it is trained by our elephant men.
Yes.
So they get tamed. Those tamed elephants are called kumkis.
Okay.
Whenever any elephant is creating problem, those kumkis are taken there. Their presence stabilizes the elephant. It gets afraid. It knows that there are individuals of his ilk which can restrain it.
Yes.
So it becomes calm. So that is the benefit of kumki. Generally we take 2 kumkis. In this case, 5 kumkis were taken because the elephant was not sedated. Anytime, whenever we have to translocate an elephant, we tranquilize it.
Yes.
In this case, it was not tranquilized because 5 elephants were there, kumkis were there. Plus, it was weak because of its injury. So I think that answers your question.
Mr. Kaushal, you know, this is, you are a forest officer. You are an expert in all this, sir. Can you tell us what happens when the kumkis met this injured elephant? These are very intelligent animals. We all know that. Jumbos are amazingly intelligent animals. Do they communicate? What kind of interaction takes place, you know, so that the injured elephant is convinced to come back calmly?
I told you, no. The elephant knows that now he can't overpower the things. So it becomes restrained. Whenever kumkis are stationed there, the wild animal becomes quiet. It won't put up much resistance.
Yes.
That is the benefit of kumkis.
Okay, kumkis are, I mean, these are amazing. I had never heard of kumkis before, so I am enlightened. I am hugely enlightened by this. I also have Anthony Rubin, who's a well-known animal activist, with me. Anthony, you know, this story highlights the threat to elephants, the danger that elephants already are in. There are so many instances in the recent past of elephants receiving grievous injuries of this kind as well. We are seeing the kumkis being used in this manner to help these elephants as well. What is your take? Are things getting better or are they getting worse for elephants?
First, thank you for having me here. And kumkis are used for different purposes. And in this particular case, like the officer said, you know, the animal is weak already. And the last stage generally is noticed that in extreme pain, the last resort they go is to under the water, just to keep their body, you know, calm and cool. And that's where, you know, this was a big alarming situation. And we all reached out to a lot of officers and chief minister's office as well. And then this happened. Kumki's proper use is to, you know, overpower the wild elephant and take control of the situation and, you know, take them into the kraal or the restrained area. In a way, it's good. In this particular case, they've never tranquilized it. Probably it's okay. But there are other cases which, because we are going into the forest most often nowadays.
Yes.
And, you know, we are not, you know, the animals are not coming to our house. We have gone to their house and they are just getting confused and, you know, that's where this crop raiding or whatever is happening. The conflict is actually raised by us. That's one thing you have to understand. And this particular case, yes, I just, I'm grateful the department has rescued this elephant. And, you know, my only hope now is the elephant has to get back, recover and get back to the wild. And that's the most important thing. The elephant's role is in the wild and not into camps, because even it's difficult for the department as well to hold elephants. It's pretty expensive to maintain an elephant. You know, they spend a lakh or plus to maintain an elephant.
Yes.
And then they can't keep taking elephants under their care constantly. I'm sure they also wouldn't be interested in long-term having many elephants in their camp, they rather prefer it in the wild, because the elephant plays a very vital role of, you know, they you know, eat so much. They
yes,
eat close
indeed.
To 200 kgs, and their frogs are, you know, once they take, you know, the poop which comes out, that becomes literally a plantation kind of a thing. And those, as they, you know, digest and the dung comes out, trees are made,
yes.
plants are made, a forest is made completely. And they are a very, very important system for our lungs, because the trees are the biggest lungs for us. And
okay.
they play such a vital role.
We've really been enlightened by this story, heartened by this story. I hope that young elephant, which was rescued after that grievous injury, is recovering well. Thank you to Kaushal ji once again for sharing your knowledge with us. Thank you, Anthony, also for giving us that perspective on a story that most people don't know very much about. I certainly am enlightened, and I'm sure my viewers are as well. So thank you very much. We wish all those elephants the very best and hope they recover very, very quickly.